Mr. Beck? Dr. Grant.
Please to meet you, Doctor.
Come in. I know how stressful these things can be, so, just think of me as one of the guys. Did I say something funny, Mr. Beck?
No, Doc, it's just, this is real important to me.
It's also real important that you be completely honest here.
Yes, I understand. I'm going to be completely honest.
Good. And let's get back to my original question. Did I say something funny, Mr. Peck?
Look, can we just drop it?
We're not here to drop things, Mr. Peck.
Okay. I mean, you're a psychologist. You're trained and you understand these things. I mean, the rest of the world walks around these fragile egos.
You're rambling, Mr. Beck.
Well, the truth of the truth is that you kind of look like Woody Allen. And when you said, just think of me as one of those guys. This case. I didn't ask for it. It just happened. It's okay. It's my case. I started it, and I just want to finish it. Is there any point in going on with this? I mean, I'm a dead man.
That's true, Mr. Beck. You died by your own hand.
It was the Woody Allen thing, right?
No one responds well to ridicule, Mr. Beck, even psychiatrists.
God almighty. I swear to God, to you, I didn't mean that as ridicule. Whatever else happens here today, that is the truth.
I'm afraid our time's up, Mr. Beck.
Tried it your way, Doc. Now we're gonna try it mine.
Get out of this office. You're not a safe man to put on the streets, Mr. Beck.
You're not a safe man to put in this office, Dr. Krantz. If I get pulled off of this case because you look like Woody Allen, I will not be responsible for what I will do. If you've got some dues to pay there, then by God, you pay them, because I will not. I will fixate on you as the instrument of my destruction. And you will never feel safe in your world again.